I love it.
I hope so.
I'm a sweet spot. Where is Rick King?
Stuff on it. Of course, BMW heated hand grips. Mark right here. Well, they didn't like come out essentially, but. It's pretty legit. I mean, it rides pretty smooth right now, taking off. Clutch setup point's a little bit different, but it's pretty nimble, I'd say. Pretty quiet. I can feel the heated hand grip starting to come on. The rev range. That definitely has got like some nice like engine braking. Just get off the throttle and it's like right there, essentially. Boxer engine definitely has like a different torque curve, I'd say. It's definitely enjoyable. I mean, it seems like there's a lot more give, essentially. You gotta manually adjust this windshield, I believe, so should be kind of fun. Can close that up a little bit. There you go. I forget, does it have a, what do you call it, like a back torque limiter or something, yeah. so it's been pretty fun. Nice deal. Like, I could definitely put some miles on this bike. It doesn't feel as big as it looks right now, or as big as it looks in general, I guess, but I'd say it's pretty sturdy. I don't have that much vibration in the bars as I do like on my DRZ, you know, so pretty legit. BMW, so you got the heated hand grips. You gotta love that. It's got plenty of torque. I mean, it being a 1200, let's hope it does. But super nimble, I guess, for its big beast stance. I don't think we'll be able to take it off road a bit, but it's definitely good side to side tossing right now. A lot of the controls are right here. You have a mouse on your left hand side that clicks. You also have a lot of features and a couple of modes you can go in, essentially. This would definitely be a blast to ride off-road. I can see why it's a really good bike. Take on twisties and whatnot, but I think the RPM cap off is at about 9 grand or so. So pretty interesting. It is a little taller for me. I did have to tiptoe it a bit, or if I just put it on one side, basically keep it in gear, I can definitely flat foot it on the left hand side, and I won't have to worry about not having the rear brake covered. But it is definitely a treat. The hand grips do warm up pretty fast. So I'm gonna go ahead and turn those down a notch. They are getting a little too toasty. But I mean, on a cold probably trip, that probably would be a lot more beneficial, essentially. Because you do have, you know, the ability to turn it up, where if you don't have hand warmers grips like I didn't, you kind of would start freezing, essentially, especially if it starts raining and getting cold. I mean, the windshield is doing a great job. I think I can put it up more, but I'm not gonna fiddle with it right now. Maybe later, when I get off, I'll go ahead and twist it up and see how actually far it goes. But I do believe it goes up higher, which would be good. I mean, you definitely want to take this bike off-road and in the rain. So it is a good thing that the windshield would be adjustable. And you do have, you do have the adjustability on there. Like I said, I'm really impressed with like the engine braking on this. It's legit. Get off the throttle even like in the high gear for this turn. Like I'm in second, I'm in third right now. And it's definitely doing a lot of the braking for me. I mean, it's not lazy at all. You just get off it and it gets off, you know? That's in a second right there. I mean, you back off the throttle and it starts slowing you down. It's legit. Now we're getting stuck into some traffic right now, but talked about these features. You have the, looks like 150 mile an hour tach right there, right in front. Speedometer, I should say. The tach goes to 10,000 above, but the red line's at 9. Pretty much all the information you can need on there, tripometer, how many miles you got left. And according to this, you got 652 miles on the odometer. So this is a brand new bike we're testing out, essentially. You have the time on there, and it looks like the date. I'm not sure why you'd have a date on a bike, but essentially it's there. Like, I guess if you're traveling, you really don't know what date it is. I ran into that. You lose track of what day, what date. It could be like Sunday the 5th or like Friday the 2nd. You know, you never know. Clutch operation is pretty smooth. I haven't felt a click or a clack or anything like that, so that's pretty good. Throttle response is there. I mean, you give it enough gas and it's gonna go. It's interesting to see how that'd be off-road, but be something definitely worth checking out, definitely worth trying out, and would be something that you can do. I don't know, I guess it'd be like a GS style school, where you can test ride off-road. Pretty zippy. I'd give it a zip factor of about 7 out of 10. Of course, riding my HP4 to a 1200 GSA is a big change, I'd say. But then again, I can't really go off-roading in my HP4. Or can I? Maybe I should just throw on some Continental TKC80s and go off-roading on it. Who knows? Maybe towards the end of when I sell it, I guess. It'd be pretty neat to just see what it looks like. Kind of like comparison to that Ducati that's out there, that Corsa with the same tires, Continentals on it. It looks pretty beefy. Looks like it's ready for adventure. I can definitely kind of almost do the same thing with the HD4. Got an overall first impression. I'd say this is a pretty great bike. I've yet to take it off-road though, so I will leave that part out until I can take it off-road. But it looks like it would be definitely a road trip bike. My ass has never felt better in a seat than on this bike. Super comfy. I would bet money that it's super comfy on a passenger as well, just because you do have a bigger seat. So that factor is pretty legit. I don't know if there is a spot for, let's see, info. You got a temperature gauge on there. You have your, I guess, coolant temperature, engine temperature, miles per gallon. I guess another miles per gallon. Speedometer, or average speed, I should say, probably. It's 29.8, and I'm doing about 50 right now. Looks like you have tire temp, actually not tire temp, tire PSI reading on here too. And then back to the date. As far as the trip goes, you basically have your one tripometer, two, and then a range. So I believe your range is gonna be how many miles you have left on the tank. Which, if this is correct, I could go 330 miles on this tank, which has I don't know how many miles on it already, but if I could do 330, then that's pretty freaking decent. I think I was getting maybe 200 out of my tank on my DRZ. And I had a Rotopax almost 2 gallon extra gas tank on the back, courtesy of pmracks.com, and that could basically total up to almost 300 miles on my DRZ without stopping for gas. Of course, I would definitely be stopping because my ass hurt from riding, you know, 200 plus miles nonstop on a DRZ stock seat with no help at all. So I kind of like limited to like probably about 100 miles, maybe 110, without stopping, just to give my ass a rest. But with this seat on this GSA 1200, I mean, it's, I feel like I could probably sit in the saddle for about a good 4 hours and not even feel a thing. Which is pretty kick-ass, I'd say. And I don't know what this is, easy, hard. Oh, here you go, electronic adjustable suspension. So you got a hard setting, soft setting, and a normal setting. So if we go with the soft setting, I guess I can adjust to that, but that would be more for like actual jumping and off-road, I would say. You'd definitely be able to test out the differences there. I don't think I've ridden a bike with this much power in an upright position. It feels like if you just romp on the gas, it's going to want to take you back even more. But it's pretty unique, I would say. There's a couple more big CC bikes out there in the adventure class. But BMW pretty much has it dialed down. definitely recommend somebody to take a test ride on this bike. Consider it for a trip. If you're more on a budget, they do have the 800 model, 700 model, both of which are twin cylinders, and then they have the 650 model, which is a single cylinder. Which it kind of makes sense because they have, you know, 1200. Take about half of that and you have a single cylinder. So that alone is going to be worth checking out as well. Just the differences on them. The only thing I would basically be concerned about on a 1200 is essentially the part where you end up like in case you drop your bike or something and you have to pick it back up. It is going to be a heavier bike. So that'd be like one concern of mine, essentially. But essentially, I mean, it's pretty decent.
Not that knob is, but I really want to turn it. Probably like pull the windshield up. But it looks like that guy was wearing a thong. Essentially.
Nice romp there. For a big bike. And I'm not sure about the weight part of it, but it would definitely feel a lot more comfortable if I could reach the ground better, I would say. To put things into perspective, I am 5'5". And I think my inseam is about maybe 30 or so, 32 tops. But I mean, if I didn't have to get off the bike, I could definitely like ride this thing all day, essentially, and be all right. It's more about the other part of like riding and then stopping, and if I'm down somewhere and I happen to tip this bike over because I'm actually using it off-road, then it'd be about picking it up. And considering I haven't been to the gym on a regular basis, like I used to, I kind of don't have the muscle mass I used to. So I definitely have to get back into that just so I can basically feel better about being able to lift the bike up. I'm pretty sure there's like tricks and stuff you can do to basically lift it up and whatnot, but I'm always thinking about like that worst case scenario. If you're like out and it's like some sand, like patchy style area or something, and you know, like what are you gonna do then, you know? You can kind of lift the bike up, but the bike's not gonna be stable enough to where it's not gonna slide out from under you again. Or if you ride against some areas, like say some creeks and streams and rivers, like what if you gotta put your foot down a little bit, get a little wet, you know, the bike might slip out from under you. I guess that's where more of the training would come in, but it's definitely something to think about, something to look at. I can't complain. I mean, on a beautiful day like today, cruising around Monterey, on the 1200 GSA. It's not a bad way to start the weekend. And so I believe I will be camping here tonight, so I can do some more test rides and stuff tomorrow. Around for this bike, it's a pleasant experience. It is super nimble. It's a lot more nimble than I thought it was going to be. It's a lot easier on the curves as well. So the only thing that would be a no for me would definitely be the seat height combination of my feet being down. It is a little higher. It's exactly what I expected it to be. And that's one thing I would probably change. I don't know if I put lowering links on it, just because that would kind of defeat the purpose of having this style bike. So it'd be more about like riding, getting more comfortable with it, so I can feel comfortable on it and actually go use it off-road. Because this bike would be the bike to take on a long trip. It's super comfy, doesn't make too much noise, it's got a nice windshield. That it moves a little bit, if I put another brace on it or something, and should give it more spots to basically mount more items. Like a camera, rear-facing camera essentially. But you do have the spot right there, right in front from BMW, for the GPS. It's essential if you're going to be in the off-road parts of nowhere lands. Starting the demos today, I figure I just start on the biggest, baddest beast. So that's how I ended up on this 1200 GSA. We could start off on the top of the line style and work my way down and see if I can get a ride on the S1000 XR, which I would be excited about trying. Because sport touring is legit. With the mirror space, you do get a lot of views in the mirrors. I just usually do a quick glance every now and then. There's not really a camera pointed at my eyes, but you can definitely have enough time to glance. I really like the upright position. It reminds me of my DRZ, except I don't have this big of a windscreen on there, but it's definitely cool. It does definitely block some of the wind resistance. Smash the resistance of the wind. This would be a fun bike. I mean, you load it up with the bags, hard bags, soft bags, whatever you want to do, and you would definitely be ready to go somewhere. Quick shift in there. Ah, you got the quick shifter going. Got that K1200, I think, right there. Pow. Am I shifting? Pow. Yes, I am. BMW teamed up with the Krapovich, and a lot of their exhaust is pretty much, it's a great team up. I love the full titanium I have on mine. I don't know what kind of exhaust options there are for the GSA. But I guess that'd be one thing to see. Second setting, it's getting a little hot, so I'm gonna go ahead and turn the heat warmers off, hand warmers I should say. Just wanted to try those out. A little hidden guy there in his BMW gear, just hiding, taking pictures. Setting on the suspension right now. It does seem soft, but not as soft as my DRZ. That was wasted. Thanks, heroes, referring to the firefighters saving a lot of the area here. Dyna means, but Dyna, it's on the gauges, must be true. BMW bikes out right now.